Subject line is pain and suffering. Dear David, you do not seem that empathic about chronic pain. Yes, Casey concentrated on the body, yet my wife and I are not at the level of Yogananda, Jesus, and so forth. The pain and seeming lack of help in our lives is doing us in. There is intermediate level here. On your video, you never really respond to the John of God questions. Well, I want to tell you that Casey and the healers of the body are still needed. Give us a break. I still cannot look out there and see that this is a dream. I see an ocean of pain. My son is part of the ocean of pain. I have terrible physical pain from several botched surgeries. My son has mental illness. My wife has been trying on the spiritual path since the early 1970s. She has studied the Course in Yogananda, another spiritual channel, yet we need healing. Please reply at the level appropriate.
Yeah. Well, helpers come in many shapes and forms, and certainly anything that brings a sense of relief could be accorded some belief, but ultimately this is a path of seeing, as Jesus says, that the truth is true and only the truth is true. And so what is apparent, that what needs to be healed, is this sense of level confusion that Jesus talks about in the Course. And I've even seen recent posts on Facebook about level confusion, and there really isn't a clear teaching being presented about level confusion. I've been speaking about this for years, it's been published, it's been freely available, and what level confusion is seeing that the mind is causative. So when we talk about Casey and many different types of healers, energy healers, and healers that seem to involve the body, what is overlooked is the very absolute central question of causation. It was Mary Baker Eddy that said that there's no mind in matter, there's no life, truth, substance, or intelligence in matter. And these were profound words. And these are words to be heeded, because this is pointing that the reason there's no mind in matter is because causation is in mind. And what we would call matter, the time, space, cosmos, is a projection of the error called ego. You will never find healing in the error, but only through the acceptance of the correction to the error. So we have, through Mary Baker Eddy and through A Course in Miracles and through my teachings, a direct route at healing, something not to be dismissed or pushed away, but to start to see that the implications of that there are no causes apart from mind is that the genetic fallacy, the belief that disease has something to do with form or circumstances, situations, viruses, all are part of the belief in false causation, that matter has causation. And the teachings that I'm sharing, that Mary Baker Eddy shares, that Jesus shares, is that the world is false perception. The cosmos, the linear cosmos, is a false perception. And pain is a wrong perspective. And if we can begin to look at this notion that pain is a wrong perspective, it points immediately toward a correction that must come in mind. So there will be no lasting relief in a personal perspective. There will never be a place where bodies can be healed. And that's why Jesus points us away from that false direction and says, don't ask the Holy Spirit to heal the body. Ask the Holy Spirit to heal your perception of the body. It's cracked perception That's the sickness. It's fragmented perception that's the sickness. It's multiplicity that is sickness. And it is singularity, singularity of mind, the oneness of all that is our true reality. And what could be the gateway to this oneness except unified perception, not fragmented perception? So if there are questions around sickness, it's good to go right into the course to lesson 136 and start to open up to the idea that seeing the parts as if they exist in and of themselves is sick. Seeing that people exist in and of themselves, seeing that objects exist in and of themselves. It's like believing in this holographic universe in which parts seem to be holes in and of themselves. That's the definition of what a hologram is. And a hologram is sick perception. There's no health in holographic perceiving. So it really points us that peace, inner peace, is what health is. Health is a state of mind. And there's nothing inherently wrong with magic, so any types of temporary measures, whether it would be medications or massage or any kind of temporary treatments, there's nothing inherently wrong about them. Even Gandhi was much more into what he called natural remedies, like herbs and so forth, and different roots from plants, and there's homeopathy, which is still kind of talking about magical means, but smaller doses of that, kind of sending the mind in to see the power of the mind. And that cannot be thrust onto a mind. It would be too terrifying for a mind to have the whole carpet, the whole tablecloth pulled out in one motion. So those, we'll call them stepping stones, are appropriate. But the whole point of using herbs or what would seem to be natural remedies would be just magical relief to come back to mind training, and mind training to come back to the acceptance that there is only mind. There is nothing physical. There has never been anything physical. That's just an attempt, you might say, in fantasy or fiction. And that realization is the most practical experience. That's the cure that is the capital C cure. It's called atonement. And that's the point of A Course in Miracles. That's the purpose of A Course in Miracles. And that's the purpose of my life as well.
Thank you.
You're welcome.